powder. My name's Jimmy James Johnny Jacob Johnson. In my career, I enjoy doing one thing and one thing only, and that's turning left. Yes, sir, I've won 5 trophies doing that. Or is that my IQ? I don't know, I forgot. What I'm really here for is what am I here for, boys?
Spinocerebellar ataxia.
Oh yeah, spinocerebellar ataxia. Other celebrities that are standing up against this cause, like me, are David Beckham and Blake Griffin.
I'm David Beckham, and I know someone who has that disease.
Blake Griffin, 2011 Sprite Dunk Champ and NBA All-Star.
This disease is a gradual genetic disease that affects the cerebellum of the human brain. This is what a deteriorated cerebellum looks like.
In most occasions, the nerve cells are damaged and eventually will disappear.
So far, modern geneticists have not found a cure yet.
There are 28 types and they are numbered according to the time of their discovery.
It's usually hereditary.
It is caused by simple dominance and sex linkage.
Doctors can find this disease in the brain through MRI and CT scans. Now that I have SCA3, I can't do anything.
Well, sure you can. If you can make a left turn, you could play NASCAR.
Hey, Jimmy, you know where the cerebellum is?
Well, I don't know.
The cerebellum is located right above the brainstem in the back of the brain.
Jimmy Johnson sucks!
Except for hereditary causes, SCA is caused by environmental factors such as brain tumors and chemical exposure.
Left turns! Left turns! As you can see, the cerebellum controls coordination, which brings us to our next point.
There are many symptoms to spinocerebellar ataxia, but the most common one is poor coordination. As you can see with this guy here, on the right side of his body, his coordination is normal. But then, as he progresses to the left side of his body, you can see how his coordination is disoriented. When he tries to point out, his hand starts shaking, and when he tries to point back at his nose, he can't really find it. This is one of the many symptoms of SCA, and you can see this in almost all of the types.
This is Aya Kito from the movie A Leader of Tears, who has SCA.
In a realistic case, an unaffected heterozygous father with an unaffected carrier mother reproduce, and their 4 probable children will be 1 homozygous dominant, 2 heterozygous carriers, and 1 recessive affected offspring.
As we start the Punnett square, we set a capital R for the dominant allele and a lowercase r for the recessive allele.
For our next step, we cross a heterozygous female with a heterozygous male, shown by capital R lowercase r and another capital R lowercase r.
As we set up the Punnett square, we put the girls on top and guys on bottom, just because it's better that way.
We we conclude for the phenotypic ratio that there are 3 unaffected offspring and 1 affected offspring.
Jimmy Johnson!
For the genotypic ratios, we conclude that there is 1 homozygous dominant, 2 heterozygous carriers, and 1 homozygous recessive. Note, though, that the heterozygous genotype is still unaffected, but it is considered a carrier because it is still carried the SCA allele.
Discount.
Double check.
Some 360s.